Florida has the most shoreline in the continental U.S. Because of that, we have a lot of eroding shorelines, especially related to sea level rise. In terms of shoreline restoration, it's just such a major need in Florida with climate change and all of the storms that our shorelines face.
We're really trying to think about all those frequent but smaller scale storms that kind of eat away at that shoreline, which then increases the vulnerability when that bigger event comes.
I get a lot of questions and concerns about sea level rise, especially with all the storms that we get. I decided that, you know, having a visual project that shows people what a living shoreline can do, how it can improve an area, is really what motivated this project.
There are a lot of people that are seeing their shorelines go away. And so what we're trying to do here with these living shoreline projects is show people what's possible and give them a system that they can come and visit so they can visualize some more ecologically friendly options that are also lower cost.
What we want to have is a shoreline, when the wave comes in, it gets absorbed. It either runs up a beach, loses its energy that way, or more importantly, we run it into oyster reefs. We run it into vegetated shorelines, and all that basically starts to consume the energy that otherwise was in that wave, so that by the time it actually gets to that infrastructure, there's no real energy left.
You're going to have that reduction in wave energy and have sediment accretion going on, and then eventually you're going to have salt marsh grass moving in that's going to really create a nice stabilization for your shoreline.
Here in Cedar Key, we have lots of demonstration projects, but we actually are expanding statewide in terms of our demonstration areas, especially based around a new material that we call reef prisms. And they are an exciting alternative to shell bags, which are plastic bags that use oyster shell. It's a common material in living shorelines. And so statewide, we are trying to test out these reef prisms as a new living shoreline material that can help practitioners move away from using plastics while also accomplishing their oyster restoration and living shoreline goals.
This park, Goffinsville, is a great example of they had a huge erosion problem due to storms, due to the fast current, and so they had to build this very large seawall here. And so today we're trying to show that you can also stabilize the shoreline, not having to use seawalls, but really implementing these living shorelines.
There's a really big need to restore and bolster our shorelines, and to the extent possible, using environmentally friendly or ecologically sound approaches are preferable to building walls and putting out rocks whenever we can.
Here locally, we have this project going on, but there's a lot of discussion happening on Amelia Island, and they're trying to implement some of these living shorelines on their downtown space to also create more awareness and education about them.
Along this shoreline, we have some artificial oyster substrate. These breakwaters are one type of commercially available structure, and then we've got the sand and the vegetation that all are part of a living shoreline. So we have projects that are essentially in line with that all over the state. And they're just ramping up now. They're just growing because the demand is so great.